Late yesterday, Republican Lamar Smith introduced amendments to SOPA, and they dramatically water down the bill's scope. They really do. The original bill amounted to the holy grail of intellectual property enforcement, as it effectively gave private companies the ability to defund websites. Say, for example, I put up a review of Halo Anniversary Edition, okay? And Viacom owns a company that does reviews, and they were just simply pissed off of me, even though I fall under fair use and had all the rights in the world to make a review of the game. They could file a false claim against me and have ReviewTech USA taken down, and I would have been screwed with no due process. That was how the original version of SOPA worked. Isn't it lovely? That was just fantastic legislation. I love how that was written. Under the amended plan, a judge would have to order ad networks to stop doing business with a site. So Viacom, with the amended bill, would have to get a court order. Okay, they'd have to go to a judge. The judge would have to green light it. There's actually due process with the new version of SOPA. So Viacom couldn't come to me and just say, hey, take ReviewTech USA down. They'd have to go to a court first. Thank you, God. There's still a little bit of an area in here which pisses me off, though, with the bill, that it gives legal immunity to financial institutions and ad networks that choose to boycott rogue sites, meaning that if there's a pending case against a website and Visa is attached to that website, or some company that posts ads is attached to that website, if they proactively bail on the website even before the court case is done, they get legal immunity. So it kind of gives incentive to companies to drop ship from any website that has a legal case against it. Which sucks, because if a court case finds the website innocent and they didn't have ads on their website for 6 months, that could hurt them big time financially. And if they're a small website, that could put them under. Now, my favorite amendment with this bill, and thank you, God, thank you, Jesus, thank Allah, thank whoever, is that Lamar's amendments also clarify that sites ending in, you ready for this, .com, .org, and .net are not covered by the bill. Hallelujah. Only foreign sites fall under SOPA's wrath, okay? So SOPA is not going to affect YouTube. SOPA directly is not going to affect Twitter. It could affect posts on Twitter. If someone from France posts a link to PirateBay.org, or I don't even, what the hell is Pirate Bay end with? I haven't been there in so long. Whatever. If they post a link to Pirate Bay, it's going to get taken down. Okay? That's an issue. But if it's a .com, .org, or .net site, it is safe from SOPA. I'm going to sleep easier knowing that. However, and I was pretty positive this was going to stay, is that the Justice Department is still going to demand that internet service providers such as AT&T and Comcast block their customers from visiting infringing sites. So, once again, PirateBay.org, guess what? Say goodbye. SOPA originally required ISPs to alter records in the net system for looking up website names, known as DNS, so that users couldn't navigate to the site. Which, screwing with DNS is, you know, it's like going to the foundation of a building and just getting a crane and nailing it. It's going to cause destruction. Thank you again for getting rid of that. There's still a crappy side to this, though. Under Smith's amendment, they would be mandated to employ some method to prevent infringing sites from rendering. ISPs could, for example, adopt tactics used by the Great Chinese Firewall to sniff for traffic going to a blacklisted site and simply block it. I hate to keep picking on it, but if you wanted to go to the Pirate Bay and SOPA passes and you live in the U.S., you're going to be redirected. You won't be allowed to go to the Pirate Bay. Have I said Pirate Bay enough in this video? I think so. So what are my thoughts on the watered down version of SOPA, SOPA 2.0, I'm going to dub it. It's a hell of a lot better than what the original legislation was that Lamar Smith came out with. It is 10 times better. The fact that .com, .org, and .net sites are protected from SOPA is a huge win. It's a huge change from what was originally written. The fact that corporations have to go to a judge first instead of just shutting down a site is fantastic. It's so much better than what was originally in SOPA. You have to give it that. But the problem with the bill is this part didn't change. Okay, fine, it's just foreign sites, but it does not give a solid definition of what a foreign rogue site would be. I don't understand why Congress and Lamar Smith are not going into more detail in the bill about what a rogue site is. If this bill is just about online piracy, then say rogue sites are considered sites that infringe on copyrights and intellectual property, okay? Just saying it's a rogue site, it can still be abused by our government and other governments around the world if rogue site is the only definition that's in this bill. And as it stands right now, even in SOPA 2.0, which is a lot better, rogue site is horribly defined. It's not defined well at all, and it's still too broad, and that's why I'm still against the bill, and a lot of other people are still against the bill, because it could still easily infringe on free speech. Lamar, you did a hell of a job. It's a hell of a lot better than it was, but you got to fix it, man. You can't. It still could censor the internet. It's not going to be the internet Armageddon, but it could still censor the internet, and free speech, man, is the most important thing we have around the world. You create a law that could threaten that, and we're in deep trouble.